Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and welcome back to Planet Zoo and our saltwater crocodile habitat in our Australian zoo. This was possibly the most ambitious build I've ever done. It took 6-7 hours, something like that, and I hesitate to even call it finished, quite frankly. This took a lot of hard work, let's put it that way. I did it all in one night the other day, and I was crazy burnt out by the end. But here we go. So what we're doing, it's kind of like if you watched my Planet Zoo planning video I did back when I didn't have a PC, we used the notepad. One of my ideas, and an idea that I've had for a long time, is, again, inspired by horror films, but kind of more films like, say, Deep Blue Sea or stuff like that, where you've got a flooded underground, underwater laboratory. And you always get these scenes as they walk past the window, and it's all dark, but then there's like bright, colourful light shining, and you see the shadow of the creature swim past, and the lab's flooding and falling apart and stuff like that. That's the theme we're going for. That's basically what I'm going to try to build here. It took so long. So what I'm doing right now is, it turns out you can't flood walls with water. I didn't really realize that, although it makes a lot of sense. So I've hollowed out a massive area in the ground, laid out the layout. We're gonna have two different exhibits, and so as you walk past, you'll see crocodiles on the left and the right, and then be able to walk out through the middle. So two separate exhibits, and what I'm basically doing is laying out the rooms underground where the crocodiles are going to go. We're not going to bring the roof in until the very end because it makes it a lot easier for me to build if I can see what on earth I'm doing. So, but I mean, that's the roof there, but I'm going to lift that up and leave it alone for now. So I've got a barrier around there. There's glass barriers around each part of the wall. That's going to keep the water in, but also act as windows as well, which makes a lot of sense. That's what you can see what I'm doing here. Glass around the sides, trying to also think about how I'm going to connect the entranceway for the zookeepers and stuff like that. Which proves to be, despite me setting it up right now, turns out I didn't set it up as well as I could have, it proves to be a massive pain in the ass. I did manage to fix it eventually, but boy, it took some work, it really did. But I can confirm both habitats have crocodiles inside of them, so big success. So yeah, just testing water. If you're going to build a habitat, something as ambitious as this, and it's going to be water-based, keep filling with water, keep testing it constantly. Now what I did here, you can see I'm putting in walls, like inner walls and windows and stuff like that. I went on Photoshop, I took a screenshot of the layout, I went on Photoshop, and I made basically a blueprint, and I laid out what rooms I wanted. So there's going to be like a break room, there's a lockers slash showers, there's a office for the manager, there's a main lab, there's a cold storage room, you know, with like big tanks. The idea is kind of like Deep Blue Sea or something like that, where, in case you don't know, they were experimenting on sharks. It was a bit ridiculous, actually. They were trying to breed hyper-intelligent sharks in order to fix dementia, I think, or Alzheimer's. They were trying to fix Alzheimer's through ultra-intelligent sharks. It was very strange. But anyways, so that's going to be the office there. The first couple of rooms you see, as I lay down the flooring here, you can see, again, that's going to be the break room slash kitchen area, so it's got a different flooring. I'm kind of trying to use floors and later walls that are appropriate for the different rooms, and different types of windows just to keep things interesting. An idea I really liked, though, was as you walk through, there's basically three corridors that you're going to follow before you leave this lab. And in the first, there's no crocodiles, that they've been blocked off, and it's not really falling apart. And then on the second, you know, there's a little bit of water on the ground. And then on the third, there's red lights blaring, the crocodiles are everywhere, and and like the whole thing is falling apart, basically. So a lot of the theming is going to be based around that as well. Excuse me. Bloody Nora. And this is basically what I'm doing for the rest of the video. We are building things and searching relentlessly through the prop items in Planet Zoo, just trying to build things, basically. I had to make tables, I couldn't make chairs effectively. Nothing in Planet Zoo is that small, annoyingly, so I can make a little table that says, you know, the office table and stuff like that. The whole thing was a bunch of prop work. It was trying to make these feel like real places that have been flooded, either suddenly or slowly. You know, the items are going to be floating around in the water. Things are going to be knocked over, some things are going to be stuck to the ground. There's going to be a lot of clipboards, prepare yourself for the clipboards. But this here was meant to be like quite a nice fancy manager's office. So it's got, you know, a nice big piece of wall art with the plant life next to it. He's got a little elephant, which I got rid of. No, he's got a little elephant. He collects things. He's a collector. He's the only one with, like, a nice room in the entire building. It's kind of like... The rest of it was slightly inspired by Alien. It's not like I could actually recreate that at all, but... Just, you know, it's a bit ramshackle and a bit rough and ready, whereas the manager has himself a very nice office, because he's management. Eat the rich. So he also has a rhino on the wall. And that's his shelving unit. This was very different for me, because this is all prop work, this is all building work, this is all decoration. This is not what I do. I've said that a lot in this series, haven't I? it's definitely outside of my comfort zone, though, I will say. But I had fun with it in the end. I just wish there was more items. Planet Zoo actually has a strange lack of props. It needs loads more. I would love like a prop pack. Nothing but every, like, chairs. I'd love a chair. The only chair in the game is the bloody desk chair. I understand that most people aren't making habitats like this, but for my sake, I'd like a prop pack with just lots of different useful things that we can use to make spaces feel more natural and man-made, you know? More natural and man-made. I heard it. You know what I mean, though? Like, true to real life. There's only so many normal habitats people can build. It's by doing stuff like this, I feel that you can mix things up on another level. Anyways, that's the office done. This is going to be a locker room / showers. Could not for life of me find a good lockers thing. I like that bas relief, though. I ended up using these. These are the modern metal thingamajiggies, whatever they're called. These are like pillars, basically, you meant to stack things upon for fountains and other like statues and stuff like that. Turn them on their side, they kind of look like rusted lockers. Kind of worked pretty well. There's going to be a lot of this, a lot of sinking shapes into things to give the illusion of, you know, it looks like a locker. That's the opening you see on a locker. We're going to put little door handles on there, as you can see, stuff like that. I need to sink those in a bit more. Light switches, doorways, air conditioners, vents. Do you know there's 7 vents in Planet Zoo? I don't know if they're new, but I've never seen them. There's 7 different types of vent in this game. It's crazy. Yeah, mad. There's going to be a lot of that just to make the whole thing look a little bit more interesting. Each room is also going to have its own colour theme. The idea is it starts off quite warm. Well, it starts off quite friendly, I would say, in colouring. You know, this is a nice teal. I feel that suited the sort of bathroom vibe. And then eventually it's going to become blaring red. So it's going to go from sort of a friendly blue to like a warning yellow / orange to the red, essentially. And basically this whole video you're about to see, well, 90% of what I'm doing now is this. It's just decorating rooms, adding things. Adding plant life, adding other things, things are cool, one of them's got away, is floating around a little bit. The idea was, if you imagine some rooms, right, so let's say you've got to imagine we're underwater for this whole thing, okay? This is an underwater research facility, and there's been a crack somewhere, like, the crocodiles, the hyper-intelligent crocodiles have grown bigger, they've gone crazy, and they've smashed through a bearing somewhere, a wall somewhere, so the whole place is leaking. Now, not every room would leak and fill at the same time. Some of them would be like a slow trickle and the water would slowly fill up. Some of them it would be almost immediate. There'd be like a gush of water and everything would fly everywhere. So again, that's kind of what I'm trying to get across in the placement of objects. There's going to be a lot of clipboards. There's going to be a lot of clipboards. Now, I've been under the impression that there is a item in Planet Zoo that looks like a stack of papers. I distinctly remember using this item that looks like a stack of papers. However, I could not for the life of me find it when playing this game. So someone please tell me if I'm crazy or not. Anyways, this is my favourite room. So this is actually inspired by Camp Cretaceous and E750. You know, you'll see I've done videos on E750 lately. And that's basically a dinosaur contained in like a cold storage tank kind of thing, right? And I thought, that's a cool idea. Let's build some of them. Which, again, Planet Zoo maybe not the best thing to build them in, but we're going to give it a go. So I'm building the tank. And the idea is these are housing some of the crocodile specimens, basically. Maybe this is what drove the crocodiles to try to break out in the first place. Because, you know, they wanted to rescue their fellow crocodilians. Anyways, just kind of just sticking things on there, just trying to make it feel sciencey, I suppose, more than anything else. The main trick was making it not look... I mean, it never looks like a hollow, water-filled tank, which would be great if I could do that, but it's never going to do that. So the trick was trying to light up the inside so it looked at least moderately interesting. I think we got somewhere near there. It definitely doesn't look like it's filled with liquid in the way I would have liked, but... Oh yeah, I lost one of the lights here. I couldn't find it for the life of me. It was too bright. I needed to calm it down. Turns out it was inside the tank. It'd be nice if we could have like a glass cylinder, but it's just not a thing. But this was as close as I could get, and I thought it was a pretty good attempt. One of them's fallen over, so the green light is off and the red light's blaring and the lights in the inside are all dead and stuff like that. Just a little bit of destruction in there as well. We're also going to be filling this with gas, because it's filled with... I keep forgetting this. You know the gas? What is it? The super cold stuff? What is it called? Why do I not remember this? Anyways, super cold gas. Please don't everyone comment, because I'll remember about 2 seconds after I finish a bloody video anyway. Nitrogen oxide. Is it? Dihydrogen oxide? Anyways, cold gas. so that's going to be sort of filling the room as well as that leaks out into the water and the area above the water. It would raise up, I'm sure, above the water. But it looks cool. So it actually looks awful in the daytime. We'll not be doing a daytime tour for this. This has been built expressly to be viewed at nighttime. Well, yeah, it's been expressly built to be viewed at nighttime. That is the whole design. Built a little sort of sciencey table, break some of the legs around, stuff like that. Gonna have to move some of these stuff. Unfortunately, the crocodiles are surprisingly picky. They really don't like to swim around if there's anything even vaguely in the area. So a lot of the tables had to get sunk underwater more than they currently were, just so the crocodiles... Because there's no point in doing this if the crocodiles aren't going to swim in front of your viewpoint, right? So... Anyways, that's our cold storage. Got into the habit right here, which I really like, of sticking things to the glass, because then, that makes a lot of sense as well. It just gives it a nice feeling of destruction. A lot of my time really was spent just trying to figure out how I can make this stuff interesting or prop-filled and natural-looking, or like realistic-looking, I should say, on point with the theming. It's the only I'm only allowed one theming per episode. There it is. Really on point with that theming. That doesn't count as a second. I'm very proud of what I did here, by the way. I'll talk about this in a sec as well. So what I'm going to do, right, this is just a table. A table's not very exciting, but this is the kitchen. It's a break area, right? This is where all the workers gather after a long day. So what I wanted to do was make it look like a kitchen. So I'm going to build kitchen counters, essentially. Kitchen counters and kitchen countertops, and later on like a little oven thing as well, like a hob. And all this kind of jazz. I thought it ended up looking really good. I was really quite proud of myself. So see here, I actually had a real image up as well, just so I had a rough idea. But I mean, it's just a series of drawers and stuff like that. Nothing particularly complex, but yeah, it looks good, doesn't it? Dead stuffed with this one, I'm telling you. There you go. Little kitchen countertop kind of thing. Give me a few of those duplicated all around. I'm going to use those again later on in the science lab as well, but without the wooden top, but with a more sciencey looking top to them. Anyways, tons of those. We're going to build a fridge as well. Just general stuff, you know? Stuff. Stuff to make it feel like an actual break room. We're also going to build a pool table. So I really did just try to push the boat out in design. You see there's a little gap there at the bottom because it's a fridge freezer. So there's a fridge space and a freezer space, of course. And sinking these black objects in just it highlights the gaps in a really nice way. It makes it look more like it actually has a gap. You see what I mean? I'm so happy with this build. Right, so this is, again, I was looking at an actual kitchen, and this is the inspiration. And it's just like a... Well, yeah, you have your bottom counters, and you have counters on the roof as well. The roof is going to come down higher, lower, I should say, than the top of what we can see here. It will sink in to nearly hit those counters, so I did have to be mindful of that. Got a little sink going. Couldn't do much better with the sink, really. And I'm going to build a... It's like a fan... I think it's a fan unit that you have above... It's a fan... for us here in my flat, it's a fan slash light. I need to put a light on it. I kind of forgot. So that's the fan slash light that would hang above the hob, which is there. There you go. Might be made out of vents, but no one has to know that. Okay, you guys know that, but don't tell anyone. Shh. So what are we doing next? And now it's time for clipboards, because there isn't anything else. I need something else, and a pool table. Unfortunately, again, same problem. There isn't anything that can be used for a ball, really. All the objects are just too large. Even the lights are too big, really, to function. I did try it out, but it's gonna be a pool table with no balls. They're floating away. That makes a lot of sense. But just the basic shape is pretty cool. There's no tapered sticks either, but I use these, you know, make some pool cues, stuff like that. And you saw a brief flash there, me trying the balls out, and also trying to have pockets in the corner, but again, everything's a little bit too big, so. And you'll see me every now and again just putting the water in to test it. As it happens, the water can be taken out of this side. Oh, that's like a message board, chipboard kind of thing, you know, where you'd stick your leaflets on and put schedules and stuff like that. There are a few posters hanging up because, you know, I just wanted it to feel lived in, like actual people would use this break room. A couple more signs up, we're going to have to get rid of those though, because they light up and it looks stupid. Unfortunately. And the flags, yeah, I put in coat racks, you know, makes sense. I ended up putting a bunch of flags in, the idea being this is an international operation between, I believe, let me remember, it's Argentina, Spain, and someone else I can't quite remember. So that's Argentina and Spain. Or Scotland and Spain, depending on... Scotland would be more like a deep blue, really. And then here I was googling flags. Ukraine, I believe, was the other country. Could be Sweden, though. Whichever you want. Follow your dreams. And so here we're going for a warm orange light. Because it's closer to the red that we're looking for in the final room that we've not done yet. As I say, things are getting worse and worse as you go through. In a big way as well. You'll see we're going to destroy the corridor in a pretty cool way, I would say. But, yeah, bringing in the orange light. But also it's warm and friendly, and that's kind of what you want from, you know, a break room or a place where your employees would hang out and have a good time. So, now some food. There's going to be lots of floating pineapples. I'm not going to pretend it all makes sense. You know, like the apples haven't floated about, but I don't have individual apples. And a bunch of apples floating looks really weird. So, the pineapples float, but the apples don't. It is what it is. Leave me alone. Bringing in a green light as well above the pool table, because that's quite a classic thing. You have a green light above pool tables. Oh, we did back home anyway. Well, we didn't. We used to have a pool table at the old house. It was a yellow light, but it was in a green lampshade kind of thing. Anyways, the final room. This is the main lab. That's the idea. This is the primary lab. So they've got their main specimen in there. They've got a few tables and stuff like that. Lots of security cameras floating around because, you know, this is an important lab. It was hard. I will admit, at this point, I was struggling to... Ironic, don't feed the animal sign. It's meant, you know, they put it in there as a joke. Sink the transformer into the ground. Hiccups. I do get rid of the water treatment. I'll admit, at this point, it was becoming difficult to... think of things, I guess. I have so many clipboards in this because it's the only thing there is. There's a limited selection of objects that are appropriate. So it began to get very, very difficult to think of new ideas for a lab when we've already got a lab. You know, this is just a slightly different lab. So, but there we go. We've got the lab tables. You'd have your Bunsen burners and stuff on that kind of thing. That kind of fills the room up in a nice way. It gives it something unique as well, which is super important. All those tables are going to get sunk down into the ground. And what I wanted to do as well was have a... Again, I had to hide this as well because a crocodile can't get through that gap somehow. But that's like, if you imagine... Imagine Godzilla 2014, right? And the chamber's flooding with gas. Is that happening in Godzilla 2014? Yeah. And the doors... Or like, just any film. It happens in like every film and every TV show ever. But like, the room's filling with gas and people are charging out and the doors are slowly shutting across, you know, to a lockdown for emergencies and people are banging on the other side. It's the same idea, basically. And that door over there, big door to shut in case of emergencies, in case, you know, this is the main lab, in case they need to shut the lab down and contain whatever's loose inside the lab, that door would slam shut. That's the theme anyway. And there's our red lights. Using some spotlights and stuff to give it that sort of vibe. I want to get the feeling that the light is leaking out from the room because it is the big bad. We're going to change up the flooring a little bit, give it a little bit of metal. The metal! Sorry. It just felt more appropriate. And the roof comes back down. The red was only there so I could see where to sink it above the pathway that I'd already established. Going to do a little bit of work on the entranceway. Just to make sure that's all black, basically, or metal, just, you know, nice and covered up, basically. looks so good. I had to change up the windows every now and again. There's a whole other room that I was meant to build in, that was meant to be yet another lab, but there was no way I was going to have enough ideas to justify it, so I got rid of that. I may bring it back, now that I think about it more, because the crocodile will swim past it a lot. So what I really wanted to do was have this feeling that the lab has started to flood, and it's not just the walls, it's, if you imagine, again, any film where the water's flooding in, like the lab's gone down, deep blue sea, you know, there's water everywhere, the whole building is falling apart, the water seeps in onto the corridors, and you know, it's falling from the roof, it's spurting out from gaps in windows, stuff like that. I really wanted to get that impression across. So using the rapids, I think it is, not this one, we get rid of this, that looks stupid. But using one of them, I think it's the bottom actually, it's like the splash zone. It's got this really nice like rippling effect that looks like water, but without having the sort of the roughness of this water here, the rapid sort of looking stuff. So using that for all the flooring, so it looks like the water's kind of flooding a little bit. And then as you get around the final corner to here, there's lots of water pouring in, you know, there's cracks in the windows and the walls, and the whole thing is tearing itself apart, so the water is just gushing in at a much higher rate. And then we have some lights. So you can see what I mean, so it goes blue, yellow, red, trying to just lean in to that. It's meant to feel like a themed zone in a theme park, you know, that's kind of my thing. And it's called The Lab. I just wanted it to feel spooky, you know, this is horror. This is what I do. It's very cliche horror, but it is horror. The lab. Sorry. Don't have anything to say about this. I'm just putting black blobs everywhere to try to hide the natural world. There. Not about that life. There you go. The lab. And then not child friendly underneath. Just to, I mean, it is. It's fine. But I'm just trying to make it spooky. And get some sort of lights going. Get a little bit of a Outrun kind of vibe going with it as well, which I liked quite a lot. I thought that looked amazing. Randomly decided to add some more lampposts, some fallen lights there, just so people don't die on their way in, I suppose. And a little entrance sign. You know what's funny though? I realised when I was making this, there is not a single crocodile. Wait, there is. I remember one. Oh no, there's not. There's not a single crocodile decoration in this entire game for the saltwater crocodile, at the very least. There is Garial decorations, which I could have used in retrospect. But it's not really the same thing. But there's not a single crocodile decoration in the whole thing. How mad is that? Saltwater crocodiles, completely neglected. Very sad. Near the end now, I was trying to sort out getting the crocodile in, which is what I'm doing right now. It was a pain, and taking a very, very long time, so I decided to do it off video. I also went and did a lot more decoration work off video as well, because at this point, this video had been about 4.5 hours long, and I was worried about fitting it in to an appropriate length time lapse. The only reason this one's so short is I made it, this is 12,000% speed, so 1200, I should say, obviously. So, we are going to hop in-game, and we shall do a finished tour. I'm going to bring in a few more crocodiles first, so we've got like 5 or 6 per habitat, and yeah, I'll see you guys in a second. Very exciting. Okay, let's give this a go. Oh, by the way, as people have correctly pointed out, I did actually forget to light up the kangaroo habitat, so that's something we'll have to get onto in the future. But anyways, you just walk on, you walk inside Uluru, this way. Wonder what could be this way? Probably something spooky. It's the lab. I just really like that. I don't know why it's just intense and in your face about it. So you head down. I am concerned about the lack of stuff here, but that's okay. You see what I mean? No, it just kind of looks like an aquarium or something. It looks pretty chill initially. It's not really a big deal. I did a little bit of detail over here. You know, nothing untoward is going on. Now, it is flooded. Can't really do anything about that, but there you go. So we've got the Australia border in there because this is Australian laboratory, of course. And there is our flooded room. I'll hop in and show you some more detail in a second. I've also put in, since the build you just saw, I put these rings around the window. I just wanted the office, the management room, to seem a little bit special. You know, to have some unique features, basically. So you see the rhino there, all the stuff that was on the shelves has sort of toppled to the floor. Look at that in a sec. Over here we have the break room, so it's got a nice little aquatic-ish display because of the showers and stuff like that. The shower text I might have to drop down, actually. And just a lot of vents and coat hooks, and there's the lockers over there in the distance. Am I on play? I am on play, cool. And an umbrella, because it's the kind of thing people would have. And there isn't really much else I can add in there. There's also some drains in the floor as well. So all nice and safe in Corridor 1, but then you turn around Corridor 2 and pachow, things are getting a little bit wishy-washy. You see on the ground, there's that kind of water texture constantly there, like it's seeping in up from the floor, or there's like a small leak, or these leaks from the ceiling are, you know, draining into the ground. Got like an update. I know this logically doesn't make much sense, but I needed something on this wall, so this is my update thing on the current status of our crocodile subjects, and this would get automatically updated, well, whenever new information is submitted by the scientists. Everyone who works here agrees to like classified information, so they put all the information here and then everyone at once can be quickly aware as they walk past what's going on. And subject 3 is the matriarch. She's very spooky, as you can see. So we walk forward a little bit more and, oh, hello buddy, there is our first crocodile. Oh, there's our first two crocodiles, both just hanging there in the cold storage room. Sometimes I'm worried I'm paused. I mean, this is all moving, but the crocodiles are so very, very still. But yeah, there's our tanks. They look better from, like, above the water, it must be said. When the lights come in, I think they look really nice. Like that. Oh, look at that. It loses some... I mean, look at that croc on the right. It looks amazing. yeah, all the lights go in, lots of vents and stuff in here. You can see the gas as well. It's kind of annoying that it seeps into the corridor. I would fix that if I could possibly ever find the gas things ever again, but they are lost to the world. Anyways, I've also got this over here. Again, I needed stuff on the wall. So it's Deep Blue Lab, because that's a reference to the inspiration. And this is their community section, their big public board thing where they all, you know, put on flyers and stuff like that in a very public manner. And management notices and stuff like that. Stuff for not the break room. And this time of year, they're having their Secret Santa, because I couldn't think of anything else to do. So this is their Secret Santa sign up. All the different clipboards are signing up, and there's some fallen presents on the ground and some fallen clipboards and lights and stuff like that. And then we walk on a little bit further. Some stuff has fallen over, as you'd expect. There's a rogue pineapple. And you turn the corner, and things are in disastrous mode. The windows are leaking, there's cracks everywhere, there's larger faucets of water spilling from the ground, from the ceiling, I should say. And we can get a look at the break room. I really like this clipboard. With lights floating, and some things floating halfway through, some things floating the other way. Little plant display there. Someone has scribbled run on a piece of paper or a scrap of wood or something. I don't know. I have limited things to work with. They scrambled run on there before they got eaten by the crocodiles, you know? Lots of fallen security cameras, fallen sheets of metal. Plant life started to grow up a little bit and take over. I'd like to make the walls a little less bare. I'm thinking like attaching some metal pipes along the walls just to make it look like there's a pipe system, maybe in the ceiling as well. I think I'll do that on my own time at some point before the next video. I think it needs it, just to look more like a lab and not like a weird room, basically. But I think if we string some metal pipe along each wall, and at the top, and some thick ones and thin ones, and maybe have it bend and follow the entire thing, that'll give it a much more labby appearance. Anyways, focus on the break room. Oopsie daisy. So you can see in there, boxes floating around, there's our main table, our kitchenette kind of thing. You can't really see the other stuff, but there's the hob and the oven and all that. I did put a light on it. Yeah, never mind. There's the pool table, and pineapples, and some pool cues that have stuck up against the window. And then on the right-hand side, we have crocodiles inside. Oh, we have several crocodiles. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, so there's the main lab. Lots of red light flooding in, as you would expect. Another clipboard stuck to it. You can see the thingamajiggy, the tank. The signs, another crocodile. I love it, they're loving this room. That's exactly what I wanted. I'd like them to move a little bit more, I'm not gonna lie. But beyond that, I'm pretty happy with what's going on here. But that's it, basically, folks. It's a lot of hard work, it must be said. There's a lot and lot of time put into this. A crazy, crazy amount of time, but... yeah, I think it has the vibe I wanted it to. Why don't we have crocodiles? Wait. Can they not get in here? Wait a goddamn minute. Right, let me... Okay, we're gonna have to go fix that. There. Oh, hello, buddy. Bloody hell. That's some nightmare stuff right there with the red lights catching in the eyes. Very cool. Yeah, so the crocodiles can only be seen from that room. I was going to have another lab,
here, basically, where I've put the subject things in, but it was just too many windows and too many walls and blah, 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 blah. I wouldn't mind maybe knocking out one window here. Maybe this gap here could be a window, and then you can see the crocodiles as they swim past. That might be cool. Don't bloody move, do they? They don't do anything. But, yeah, that is Deep Blue Lab, our crocodile habitat. So what I'll do is I'll bring a little staircase up there, you'll go off to the exit, and you'll go off to the next habitat. Now, technically, we're not done. I do still have to build a habitat for the blue-tongued lizard. I don't have a fantastic idea for that, and we are very close to the end. Basically, you come out here, and this is the exit here, so, you know, we're limited amounts of space right now. If I come up with something, like a great idea, like a unique idea, or something I really want to build, we will do it. I promise we'll do it, and we'll build something really cool for the skink, just like we did for the eastern brown snake. If not, we won't. So feel free to leave suggestions down below. I did like the idea someone suggested once of building, like, a glowing cave. I don't know how I would do it, but, like, glowing mushrooms and stuff like that. Everywhere, and glowing stalactites, and glowing in the water, just glowing. Everything glows. It's like a fluorescent life cave. I really like that idea. I don't know what it's got to do with the skink, but I do like the idea, so maybe we'll do that, and this can carry on to there, and then I'll just get rid of that building and fold around to there. That might be the play. We'll have to wait and see. I have a path here, don't I? Yeah. We'll have to wait and see. But either way, thank you so much for joining me. Hope you enjoyed the build. There it is, right there. I will see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love as always. Oh, and do hit the like button if you enjoyed this build and appreciate the mammoth amount of time it took. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.